गुड मॉर्निंग टुडे आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग मैट्रिसेस द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज डेरिवेटिव सो दिस डेरिवेटिव टॉपिक इट वाज इन प्रीवियस क्लास आल्सो देयर वाज इंट्रोडक्शन टू दिस डेरिवेटिव सो इन दिस 12th class, you will have to study derivatives or differentiation. Now, so far as definition is concerned, derivative, if I have a curve y equal to fx. This is equation of a curve. So it is in xy plane curve. If I put small incremental change, that is delta y and delta x, mean to say y is given a incremental change y plus delta y and x is given an incremental change x plus delta x where delta x and delta y they are small incremental changes small incremental changes so if I have a curve y equal to fx delta x and delta y These are small incremental changes. So therefore, I can say if I put the small incremental change delta y in y, so this will equal to f of x plus if incremental change is given to y, the incremental change is also to be given x. So this will become f of x plus delta x. So if I say this is equation first, this is equation second, so I can subtract second and first equation. So I will have y plus delta y minus y, this will equal to f of x plus delta x and minus of f of x so this y negative and positive they will cancel delta y will equal to f of x plus delta x minus f of x now if I divide both sides by delta x so my equation will become delta y upon delta x is equal to f of x plus delta x minus fx upon delta of x so if I apply limit here as delta x approaches to 0 so I can write limit delta x approaches to 0 delta y upon delta x will equal to applying the limit to this side limit delta x approaches to 0 and f of x plus delta x minus f of x upon delta x now this limit this quantity is generally denoted by dy upon dx and this will equal to limit delta x approaches to 0 f of x plus delta x minus fx upon delta x So this is
the definition of a derivative. Or in other words, sometimes we write this derivative as limit h approaches to 0 f of x plus h minus fx upon h. So both these have the same meaning. This is called derivative of so this is the definition. Sometimes we write f dash x instead of dy upon dx. So notation is the same. I can write it as f dash x equal to limit h approaches to 0 f of x plus h minus fx upon h. So this is the value of definition of a derivative. So this is the definition as per algebraic part. Algebraic point of view, this is the definition of a derivative. So this was also in your previous class, you might have studied there the derivative. Then we have elementary formulas of derivative. So this definition f dash x equal to has been, this formula has been derived from first principle, or it is called Ebenezer. So from first principle, this formula of derivative is derived. So if f is a real valued function and a, b, any number lying in the interval a b, this is closed interval, so therefore I can say f of f dash will equal to f of limit h approaches 0 f of, instead of x I can write f of a plus h minus f of, instead of x it is a upon h. So this is the derivative of the function at point a. Now there are some basic formulas which you must be knowing. The very first is basic formulas which are used in calculating exercise questions. So the first formula is d upon dx, that is derivative of x power n. So this is equal to n x n minus 1. This is the formula which is mostly used while solving the questions. So number 2 is derivative of ax plus b power n. So this is equal to very common formula, n times ax plus b power n minus 1 into d upon dx of ax plus b. So this is written as n ax plus b power n minus 1 into b is constant, its derivative is 0, and ax its derivative will be a. So that means this formula is equal to this formula. So this is the derivative of ax plus b power n. So you will have to remember this formula also. These are very important formulas which you must be knowing. So these are the formulas which are mostly used in physics in derivations. So third one is d upon dx of log x. So this is 1 upon x. So these are common formulas, mostly they are used. Then d upon dx of e power x, this is logarithmic function, this is exponential function, so it will equal to e power x. Then we have another formula, d upon dx of a x. So this is a x into log of a. Then sixth one, we have constant derivative, any constant, say c, this is 0. Then seventh is we have d upon dx, trigonometric functions, sin x. So this is cos x. Mostly you might have seen in your previous class, their proofs are also given there, and this is proved by first principle, that is ab initio principle. D upon dx of cos x, this is minus sin x. Then d upon dx of tangent x, so this is secant square x. So these formulas will be used while solving the questions. So if these are known to you, then it will be easy for you to solve the question. So tenth one is d upon dx of secant x. So it is secant x tangent x, d upon dx of cot x. So this is minus cosecant square x. Then cosecant x, it is cosecant x into cot x and minus tan. There are some more formulas. So those formulas are d upon dx of inverse trigonometry functions. So they will be taken later on. Then these main formulas which are to be used, I have written here. Now this, after this, you have already continuity chapter, continuity and derivability. Continuity you have already gone through, it was exercise 5.5. So my colleague has very elaborately covered this topic. After continuity comes this derivative. So these are main formulas. So you can see these formulas. After this, I will take exercise 5.2.
So it is a exercise comprising 10 questions.
So you will remember these formulas. If these formulas are known to you, it will be easy to solve the questions. So exercise is 5.2. It is 5.2. 5.1 you have already covered. So 5.2 is differentiate the function. You have to find differentiate You have to find the derivative. The very first question is given as sine of x square plus 5. So you have to find derivative of this function. So let we put this function equal to sine x square plus 5. So this is very simple question. Now differentiate both sides with respect to x. This stands for with respect to x. So when you will differentiate this, so d upon dx of y will equal to d upon dx of sine of x square plus 5. So just I have written the formula d upon dx of sine x. This is known to you. It is cos x. Number of times in physics you might have seen this formula of derivative. So here the derivative of sine is cos. Here x is where I consider this as x. So this will be cos of x square minus 5 into derivative of this x square plus 5. So this will be equal to cos of x square plus 5 into derivative of x square. So x square derivative is again I have shown the formula d upon dx of x power n. This is n time x n minus 1. So here n is equal to 2. So this will be 2x 2 minus 1. That is 2x1. That is 2x. So you can write here 2x plus it is constant, its derivative will be 0 because derivative of constant is 0. So it will be 2x plus 0. 2x, write this first. 2x into x square plus 5. So this was very simple question. So derivative of given function is this much. So this was the first question. So first 2-3 questions, they are very simple. Then there is third question, differentiate sine of ax plus b. Same, it is similar to the previous one. Let this equal to sine of ax plus b. Again we have to differentiate both sides. So when you will differentiate, it will be dy upon dx equal to d upon dx of sine of ax plus b. So again, derivative of sine is cos of x. So I can write cos of, instead of x, you will write ax plus b into derivative of ax plus b. So this will equal to cos of ax plus b into derivative of ax. A is constant. So b upon dx of ax. Now a is constant. You can take constant in this manner. So derivative of x, it is 1 into 1, that is a. So its derivative is a plus constant derivative is 0. So a plus 0, it is a. So a cos of ax plus b. So this is the derivative of the given function sine of ax plus b. So this was the question second of this exercise. So next question, they are very simple one. You might have done in your previous class. So there are 9 to 10 exercises. So in this class, you will in detail solve the derivative questions. So next question is, so before I take next question, let me write algebra of derivative. That means that if I have a function fx and gx, these are the two functions, then derivative of fx plus gx, these formulas which I am going to show, they are to be used while solving the questions. So derivative of sum of two functions, this is sum of two functions fx and gx. So this is equal to d upon dx of fx plus d upon dx of gx. So this formula is to be known to you. This is the first. Then second is d upon dx of fx minus gx, mean to say derivative of difference of two functions. This was sum, this is difference. So this is equal to d upon dx of f of x minus time d upon dx of g x. So this is the second formula. These two formulas, they will be used in solving exercise questions. So again, there is another formula, that is fx into gx. This is called product rule. This was sum, this was difference, and this is product. So its derivative of product of two functions is equal to, according to formula, first function into derivative of second function, then second function into derivative of first function. So again, this formula will be used in solving exercise questions. Number 4 is d upon dx of fx upon gx. This is called quotient.
Sum, difference, product and quotient.
So this is equal to gx its square, then gx into derivative of fx minus time fx into derivative of gx. So these are the 4 basic formulas which are used. So in short, if I have a function u and v instead of fx and dx, so this will be d upon dx of u, d upon dx of v, and sometimes it is written in this way, or you can say u plus v, its derivative is u dash v dash. Dash means derivative. Again, u minus v, its derivative, it is u dash v dash. And same is the case with the product rule. So these formulas are given in your book. You can also see these formulas from your book. This was first, second, third is u upon v, uv, its derivative. So this is product. So I can say u v dash v u dash. So this is the formula of product. And last is u upon v, its derivative. So this is equal to v square v into u dash u into v dash. So these are very important formulas. These are to be remembered by you. So let me take the next question, that is question number 6. This says cos x cube into sine square x power 5. So this is the 6th question of 5.2. Now here, let y equal to cos x cube sine square x 5. So here we have 2 functions. If I say this is u and this is v, so this is the product of the 2 functions. Now if I have to differentiate this function, so I will apply this formula here, product rule. So this will be product rule will be used here. So by differentiating with respect to x both sides, so I will apply d upon dx of y, this will be d upon dx of cos x cube into sine square x power 5. So it is a product rule. So by product rule I will apply the formula. So this will equal to first function, this is first, this is second, or this is u, this is v. So according to formula I will have to write first function, that is
into the derivative of second, that is d upon dx of sine square x pi power 5. So first into derivative of second. So you can write in this way. Then plus second is sine square x power 5 into derivative of first. So its derivative d upon dx of first, that is cos x cube. So on simplification, this will be cos x cube will remain as it is. Now you have to take its derivative. So its derivative 2 times sine x power 5 into derivative of x 5 plus here sine square x power 5 into its derivative. So derivative of cos is minus sine x cube into derivative of x cube, it is 3x square. So this will equal to cos x cube 2 times sine x 5 into this, its derivative will be 5 times x power 4 plus sine square x power 5 plus into minus, you can write minus here, and again into sine x cube 3x square can be written here. So finally this will be 2 into 5, it is 10 times cos x cube into sine x power 5 minus sine 3x square can be written first, and then sine square x power 5 into sine of x power 3. So this is the derivative of d upon dy upon dx of the given function. So in this way, this question was to be solved. So there is one more question. So these are very simple questions. So I am taking next question after this question. Fifth question of the same exercise, sine of ax plus b upon cos of cx plus d. So this is question number 5 of exercise 5.2. So let this equal to y or fx. So we have to differentiate this. So if y is equal to sine ax plus b
upon cos of cx plus d. Now here, if I differentiate this, both sides, so this will be dy upon dx, and here this will be equal to d upon dx of sin ax plus b upon cos of cx plus d.
So here in this question I will have to apply the quotient rule. And what is quotient rule? Quotient rule is d upon dx of u v dash. So this is equal to d square v into u dash u into v dash. So this formula will be used here in this question. So this is v and this is u. So this will equal to, according the formula, v square, that means cos square cx plus d. So this is v square, then v, this is cos cx plus d into u dash, this is u dash, so d upon dx of sin ax plus b minus sin u, u is sin of ax plus b into v dash. V dash means d upon dx of cos of cx plus d. So this will be the simplification by applying this formula. So further we can simplify this question. So cos of cx plus d, it will remain as it is. So far as sine, derivative of sine, so it is cos, so it will be cos of ax plus b into derivative of ax plus b. B is constant, its derivative will be 0, and ax, a is constant, derivative of x is 1, so you will write simply a here. So minus sin, sin of ax plus b will remain as it is. Now derivative of this cos, so derivative of cos is minus sin times, so minus sin cx plus d into derivative of c will be here constant of constant d, is derivative will be 0 over cos square cx plus d. So this can be further simplified. This will be a, we can write first cos of cx plus d into cos of ax plus b minus time c can be written first sin of ax plus b, this minus and minus will become plus, so sin of cx plus d and whole upon cos square cx plus d. So if you want to further simplify it, it can be simplified. So this is the derivative of the given function. We can further simplify it in one or two steps. So here is cos cx plus d. So this can be separated. I can write a of cos cx plus b and cos of
ax plus b upon, here I can write cos square cx plus b. So separating these two factors, c times sin of ax plus b into sin of cx plus b upon cos square cx plus d.
So I have separated these two factors.
So this can further be simplified. So this is the value of b upon dx of the given function. So on simplification, I can write, so here a times, this is cos square cx plus d, and cos cx plus d is also written here. So I can say cos of ax plus b, and this square will cancel with it. So here will be cos of cx plus d plus here cos of cx plus d and sin cx plus d, it can be written as sin of ax plus b upon cos of cx plus d into sin of cx plus b upon cos of cx plus d. So this was square. Square can be written in this way. So a times cos ax plus b into cos of cx plus d plus c times, this can be written as sin upon cos this can be written tangent of. So this was the answer or derivative of the given function was whatsoever it was. So this is the answer. So up to here, the next day we will take the next exercise, that is 5.3. Till then, it is bye.